Your Excellencies, Honorable Ministers, Heads of Delegation, dear delegates, ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed my great honor to declare open this landmark 39th session of the Assembly of the International Civil Aviation Organization. On behalf of the Council of ICAO, Secretary General Dr. Fan Liu, and the many honored ministers and delegates to the Assembly with us today, I wish to first extend a very warm welcome to our three distinguished guests, His Excellency Marc Garneau, Minister of Transport of Canada, His Excellency Philippe Couillard, Premier of Quebec, and His Excellency Denis Coderre, Mayor of the City of Montreal. It is also my pleasure to welcome the many representatives of international organizations and other participants from around the world who are with us here today and who are working closely with us to foster the safe, secure, efficient, and environmentally sustainable development of international civil aviation. This assembly stands to become an historic milestone, setting new records for its level of participation and the very significant amount of work to be undertaken here by world governments. It is also expected to endorse a resolute step to mitigate greenhouse gas emissions by the international community and sector-wide action at the global level. But before we look ahead, let us also appreciate just how far ICAO has come in the 3 years since our 38th assembly. In the first place, we have strengthened our core activities relating to global air transport interoperability through the consensus-driven development of international civil aviation standards and recommended practices. Our consultative processes have been made more efficient, and we are focused on ensuring that states are better prepared to implement new ICAO provisions. More effective impact assessments are being carried out, and we are making sure that sufficient guidance material on any new measures is made available to our states well in advance. Our safety and security audit programs under the continuous monitoring approach have been optimized to ensure timely validation of states' corrective action plans to address identified deficiencies. This helps to ensure robust feedback that further enhances the overall standard setting process. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now universally acknowledged that air transport is a critical driver of socio-economic development and prosperity for the nations and peoples of the world. Article 44 of the Chicago Convention sets out the objective for ICAO to foster the planning and development of international civil aviation so as to ensure its safe and orderly growth throughout the world, meet the needs of the world for safe, regular, efficient, and economic air transport, and ensure that every contracting state has a fair opportunity to participate in international air transport. However, effective implementation of ICAO standard is key to any state's preparation to take full advantage of the benefits that international air transport can realize for citizens and businesses. And our citizens deserve safe, secure, efficient, and reliable air transport from everywhere to anywhere in the world. In recognition of these facts, significant efforts have been focused by ICAO over the past 3 years on enhancing the level of effective implementation of our standards worldwide. Our No Country Left Behind initiative has been guiding this transformative and organization-wide change. Our regional offices have become very active partners in this process, requiring adjustments to their work programs and resourcing to better monitor and address local needs. This has led to the realization of more targeted national and regional plans of action with clear targets, timelines, and accountabilities, and to more dedicated support from ICAO headquarters. Our technical cooperation and assistance activities have been reinvigorated as well, mainly through the development of new tools. We have also established the new ICAO program for aviation volunteers in order to take advantage of the knowledge, experience, and the passion of our aviation professionals, whom I kindly invite, please, to participate in this effort to assist states in need. In the area of global aviation training and related human resources development capacity building, ICAO has made great strides in the past 3 years. We have also formalized our next generation of aviation professionals efforts as an official program, and we are encouraging the best and the brightest through the Young Aviation Professionals Program, which we run cooperatively with IATA and ACI. The new ICAO Museum that we inaugurated in 2014 is also helping to inspire future generations of aviators. I invite all of you to visit the museum to rediscover the remarkable history of our industry and ICAO. Consistent with our No Country Left Behind initiative, ICAO has been targeting outreach efforts to highest level decision makers in states, encouraging their commitments and recognizing their accomplishments. Later this morning, for example, it will be my great honor to present the inaugural Council President's Certificates of Recognition to 14 states for their achievements in improving their levels of effective implementation of ICAO's safety standards. Ladies and gentlemen, ours is a very dynamic sector, and public confidence is of crucial importance to the sustainability of our industry. I therefore believe that ICAO must be prepared to respond comprehensively and effectively to all emerging issues consistent with our mission. This past triennium has proven instrumental in this regard, as ICAO rose to the occasion in coordinating our community's response to the challenges posed by Malaysian Airlines Flight MH370 and aircraft tracking, conflict zone risk mitigation measures, the pandemic response to the Ebola virus, and the emergency support to Ecuador following its major earthquake. These priorities speak to why you will be asked to endorse new ICAO emergency response strategies, which will help us to act with even greater urgency and effectiveness in the years ahead. We have also been much more proactive than in the past at anticipating new requirements, whether for remotely piloted aircraft systems, commercial suborbital flights, new cybersecurity threats, and other emerging challenges. It is essential that we continue to strengthen and deepen ICAO's role as a nexus of coordination for states and industry, as we jointly ensure global civil aviation development while addressing the challenges of sectoral growth. The ICAO Council has played a key leadership role in this process, initiating annual offsite strategy meetings, conducting information gathering missions in ICAO regions, and with the assistance of regular and comprehensive industry briefings. The Council has also worked closely with the Secretariat to enhance the efficiency and effectiveness of the organization through performance management and evaluation, including development of a performance assurance and risk management framework, as well as robust ethics and internal audit regimes. Furthermore, the organization has been working tirelessly to promote the importance of civil aviation to socio-economic development, as well as its prioritization in national and regional investment and development planning. One very important aspect of this work has been our efforts to coordinate and optimize global partnerships for aviation development, including among non-aviation stakeholders, such as sister UN agencies, financial and economic development institutions, industry bodies, and donors. The realization of the importance of this partnership is at the heart of our new ICAO World Aviation Forums, and we were greatly encouraged to see so many of you in attendance at our second of these events yesterday. Ladies and gentlemen, as is clearly evident, our organization has undergone a number of transformational changes and embarked upon many new programs these last few years. And it is noteworthy that all of these efforts have been undertaken without prejudice to the need to deliver on all of the instructions and expectations of states, which were detailed at our last assembly in 2013. With respect to these expectations, the commissions and executive committee for this year's meeting will be considering several working papers, reviewing our accomplishments under all strategic objectives of the organization, as well as on proposals for future development. The ICAO Global Plans for Aviation Safety and Air Navigation are now guiding state activities and sector-wide investment on to an unprecedented level. You'll be asked during this meeting to adopt several new provisions to make them even more effective, especially in addressing our safety management and aviation system block upgrade strategies. And the success of these documents has been such that we are now considering similar global strategic plans for aviation security and facilitation and for air transport economic development, which will be also be asked to endorse. We will be reporting on our efforts to promote risk-based outcome-focused and sustainable responses to security threats and to balancing effective control measures with system-wide connectivity and efficiency. We will also be reporting on developments relating to our work with travel documents and identity management under the ICAO TRIP program, international air transport liberalization, and consumer protection. In order to implement all of the anticipated activities, a resource-based budget for the coming triennium has been submitted for your endorsement. In it, we have outlined the efforts being made to mobilize and leverage additional resources through new synergies and partnerships. The last item I will highlight for you is the very extensive environmental work that we engaged in. In particular, on all of the basket of measures to reduce aviation emissions. This includes technological innovations, operational improvements, the use of sustainable alternative fuels, and of course, market-based measures. I am very pleased that the first ever CO2 emission standard for aircraft has been recommended by the Committee on Aviation Environmental Protection for adoption by the ICAO Council. And perhaps, most importantly, following a lengthy and detailed consultative process, the Council is submitting to this Assembly a draft resolution on a global market-based measure to mitigate international flight emissions. Of course, the adoption of the resolution is just the beginning. A lot will need to be undertaken between now and the 40th Assembly by both ICAO and your governments and in concert with the industry to make the proposed carbon offsetting and reduction scheme for international aviation fully and meaningfully operational from 2020. We will need to complete our work in developing and establishing the registry framework, monitoring, reporting and verification process, and emissions unit criteria. But I must say that I am greatly encouraged that states representing more than 80% of international traffic have now volunteered to participate as of the pilot phase in 2021. Ladies and gentlemen, the World Air Transport Network today conveys some 10 million passengers on about 100,000 commercial flights daily. Think about that. For 2015, that totaled 3.5 billion passengers and more than 34 million flights. And by 2030, these figures are anticipated to double to over 6 billion passengers and 60 million flights annually. Air transport is by far the safest mode of transport, and our safety records improve steadily, with 2015 again recording the lowest accident rate ever. Aircraft today are 70% quieter and 80% more fuel efficient than decades ago. And we are currently exceeding our 2% annual fuel efficiency improvement goal. These remarkable achievements are the result of the efforts of our member states, airlines, airports, air navigation service providers, manufacturers, and other stakeholders. And of course, the dedication and professionalism of the hardworking civil aviation community globally, worldwide. Your organization, ICAO, has been endowed with a unique leadership role to set the global policies, programs, and standards, and to provide the coordinating platform for governments and industry to collaborate and achieve results. This assembly will be one for bold decisions and a time to refine our vision for how air transport can be of even greater service to states and regions, businesses, and travelers in the exciting years ahead. The eyes of the world are now focused squarely on ICAO for concrete action to make our industry even greener and more efficient to the benefit of future generations. I kindly urge you all to again demonstrate, please, our historic strengths of cooperation, compromise, and consensus. I am confident that we will rise to the expectations of the global community. Excellencies, honorable ministers, delegates, dear colleagues, I am deeply honored for the unique opportunity to lead our great organization at this time. And I'm very grateful for your support and for all that we have been able to accomplish working together. Let us progress our work in the spirit of the preamble to the Chicago Convention in order that international civil aviation can continue to help create and preserve friendship and understanding among the nations and peoples of the world, and to promote global security, peace, and prosperity. I very much look forward to this journey, and I wish us all a very productive and successful 39th session of the ICAO Assembly. Thank you.